for discussion is time management. See, time management, not in general, particularly while taking your paper. Okay? It is very difficult to manage the time while writing the paper. I am very much sure you all know that in each subject we have some troublesome sections, right? In English, particularly section A, it takes a lot of time. So when you know the structure of the paper, it actually reduces the time to understand it and you are able to attempt your paper in time. Clear? So first point which we are going to take under time management is knowing the structure of your paper. Your teachers must be telling you about the blueprints, how the question paper comes. Each subject has its own pattern, right? If you understand that, you would be able to understand how to attempt it. Second point, 15 minutes have. This is very important. You get 15 minutes for reading. Please utilize it judiciously. Because when you use these 15 minutes to read instructions, to see the paper, skimming through the paper basically. When you skim through the paper, you see the questions which are easily identified. Like easy questions, you can identify them very easily. And if you attempt those questions first, you're going to gain the momentum. Okay? So please read the question paper properly in 15 minutes. See what you can attempt, what you can exclude, because that is important. Now, then we allocate time for each section. Like, for example, in English we have three sections, reading, writing and literature, right? So you have to allocate time for each section. It has two categories basically. Allocation has two categories. Allocating time for section and allocating time for each question. Fine? Now what I mean by each question? See, every paper has 2, 3, 1, 5, 6 mark questions. Okay? You should know how much time you have to spend on each type of question. If you're spending 5 minutes on 1 mark question, 2 mark question, obviously time. So you need to learn how to. This can happen only when you are doing practicing. Practicing will happen when you will read the sample papers, try to attempt the questions. That we will do, but first of all, understand how you can save your time. Okay? See, effective time management not only ensures that you are able to complete your paper in time, but also you are able to write it, present it properly. What happens usually? Students give all their they are taking giving all the effort in one section, two section, maybe 2, 3 questions which they know. And when they they are just if they want to see if they are, please have a watch on your eye and your watch also. Have an eye on your watch also. Why? Because you have to see whether you have distributed your time evenly or not. If you have not done that, then you're going to be wasting your time. Okay. So remember, first is know the structure, 15 minutes have, then allocate time per section, per question, okay? If you're doing it, you're going to do well, I'm very much sure. Then what is next? If a particular question takes a lot of time, right? Leave it right at that time only. Why? Because you have to give time to other questions also. So you can come back again if the time permits, you can come back again and just do that question, attempt that question, but not. Do not do that at that time. Okay? Leave it. Next thing, which is not actually time management, but I will take it. Do not leave any question unattended. Okay? Why is this? Maybe if you're unsure about any question, math, science, SST, English, Hindi, whatever it is, or computer. You should not leave any question unattended. Maybe if you have done it, you may be given or be permitted partial credit. You may get partial credit for it. Right? Okay? Getting it? So do not leave any question unattended. CBSE doesn't deduct your marks for attempting questions. Even if you're unsure about it, do not leave it. Take partial credit or maybe minimum credit, but you will get something if you write. Clear? Last but not the least, kindly save some time for reviewing your answers. Reviewing means revision in your words, it is revision. If you are leaving some time for reviewing your paper, if you have left any question which is unattempted, if you want to add some point, if you want to highlight, you can do that. So initially, if you if you are paying attention to the first, two and third point, allocating time, 15 minute hacks and knowing the structure of the paper, you will be able to get some time for reviewing your paper also. Fine? एनी क्वेश्चन, डू यू फील एनी प्रॉब्लम व्हाइल अटेम्प्टिंग एनी पेपर? जितना मैंने बताया उतना काफी था. इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू नो योर पेपर, इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू एलोकेट टाइम, इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू नो द क्वेश्चन रिक्वायरमेंट, डू नॉट स्पेंड टू मच टाइम ऑन इट. एंड व्हाट एल्स? लास्ट क्या, व्हाट पॉइंट आई डिड आई टेल यू? रिविजन, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. You people never give time for revision. Never. You are not left with time actually. Why it happens? Because you do not know how to manage your time well. So manage your time well and good luck for your mock paper. Fine. And refine your time management skills so that you are able to attempt your actual board paper.